Yeah, this was actually a fascinating story. So there's a hydrogen storage facility up and running in San Bernardino County, and the company behind it says this will prevent Californians from losing power during natural disasters and take stress off our power grid. In the middle of the Mojave, off this secluded desert road, the future of clean energy is being tested with high hopes.
If you think a little bit into the future, you know, we're running out of options of how to power our lives.
Ivo Goff-Eschrich is the senior project engineer for GKN Hydrogen, a company working to be the first to provide sustainable green energy to the world. They're doing just that with this new type of hydrogen storage that provides electricity using two things, solar power and water.
So hydrogen really is one of the most abundant elements here, so it is very cheap. It's in every piece of water, right? Water is hydrogen and oxygen combined.
While concerns about hydrogen gas have long been related to its explosive nature, GKN says this new type of hydrogen storage is safe.
You put power in, you put water in, that enables us to create hydrogen out of that. We store the hydrogen, we store it as a metal, as a solid, which means there is no way it's going to blow up in your face.
This was the first hydrogen storage unit in North America, and it's been up and running here in the Mojave Desert since January of 2023. In fact, it's the only one in the state. This unit alone could power an average-sized home for a month. The project is being funded by the California Energy Commission as state officials look for innovative new ways to create more clean energy. So how does it work? The sun provides energy to power these solar panels, which is combined with water and fed into the 20-foot storage center. That's where hydrogen is created and stored as powder called metal hydrides. Once the demand for power increases, the metal hydrides are converted into hydrogen gas, which turns into electricity using fuel cells. The only waste from the process is water, clean enough to drink. Engineers say these metal hydrides can be stored for decades, providing peace of mind we'll never be in the dark. Project manager Chris Tasser says this type of energy could be a game changer for the state in situations from natural disasters like earthquakes to rolling blackouts during scorching summer heat. So why aren't there more of these?
We are educating different clients, also power utilities and also wineries to be off-grid. It just takes a little bit of time and maybe more incentives.
The Golden State appears to be embracing the new technology. In July, government officials announced California will be the first state to receive federal funds to create hydrogen hubs, regional networks producing clean energy for vehicles, manufacturing, and electricity.
And so hydrogen is really the end game. There is no way around it. It is absolutely abundant and is recyclable. So the only way to get to a completely sustainable energy economy is through hydrogen. There really is no other way.
So the funding will be extended by the California Energy Commission for another year and a half. And Chris Tasser, project manager for who you just heard from in the story, he's actually applying for another grant to fuel hydrogen cars with a similar system. So yeah, we shot that back in the middle of the summer. So they picked the Mojave Desert because not only does it get the extreme heat, it gets the extreme cold. So it's a real test of these storage tanks, like showing that, hey, this can hold up to pretty much any climate.
So one of the criticisms of solar panels that you would see, on the ground is it takes up too much space. How big of an area does this whole plant?
That was like, those moving pods that you see? Mm-hmm. Like, this is the size of one of those. It doesn't take up much space at all. Yeah.
That's great.
Pretty fascinating.
Yeah. And the only one in the state here, in SoCal. Yeah. So we'll keep watching.
Sounds like more are coming.
We hope so.
That's a good sign right there.